There are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible giants in the sky. When you're way up high and you look below at the world you left and the things you know, little more than a glance is enough to show you just how small you are. When you're way up high and you're on your own in a world like none that you've ever known, the sky is lead and the earth is stone, you're free to do whatever pleases you, exploring things you never dare cause you don't care. When suddenly there's a big, tall, terrible giant at the door. A big, tall, terrible lady giant sweeping the floor. And she gives you food and she gives you rest, and she draws you close to her giant breast. Know things now that you never knew before. Not till the sky. Only just when you made a friend and all you need to know she's big, but you don't feel small. Someone bigger than her comes along the hall to swallow you for lunch. And your heart is lead and your stomach's stone, and you're really scared being all alone. And it's then you miss all the things you've known, and the world you left and the little you own. The fun is done, you steal, you can and run. And you scramble down and you look below, and the world you know begins to grow. The roof, the house, and your mother at the door. The roof, the house, and the world you never thought to explore. And you think of all of the things you've seen, and you wish that you could live in between. And you're back again, only different than before. After the sky, there are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible, awesome, scary, wonderful giants in the sky.
Caught a bus in Amarillo. It was going to San Antonio. Had a brand new cardboard suitcase and a window seat. And I thought that I was something. Had a dream I'd travel far. Maybe be a restaurant hostess. Maybe be a movie star. And the bus from Amarillo raced a train along the track. But I never looked behind me, 'cause I wasn't coming back. The ticket, but I didn't have the nerve. Yeah, the bus from Amarillo had me so damn terrified that I got off at the next stop and I never took that ride. I didn't want that one-way ticket to nowhere. I didn't disappears. How how the days can turn to weeks, and how the weeks can turn to years. And it's funny how you wait for things and want that lucky day. And it's funny when the bus stopped, I got off and walked away. Yeah, the bus from Amarillo, I can hear it still go by. Guess I missed my only chance, and now I swear I don't know why. I guess life's a one-way ticket to nowhere. God, wish I was traveling free. Once I had a one-way ticket to go. For me, anything was possible for me. I stick with real things, usually facts and figures. When information's in its place, I minimize the guessing game. Guess what? I don't like guessing games or when I feel things before I know the feeling. How am I supposed to operate if I'm just tossed around by fate? Like on an unexpected date with a stranger who might talk too fast or ask me questions about myself before I've decided that he can ask me questions about myself. He might sit too close or call the waiter by his first name or eat Oreos but eat the cookie before the cream. And what scares me the most, what scares me the most is what if when he sees me, what if he doesn't like it? What if he runs the other way and I can't hide from it? What happens then if when he knows me, he's only disappointed? What if I give myself away to only get it given back? I couldn't live with that. So I'm just fine inside my shell, shame mine, that way I get the best view. So that when he sees me, I want him to. I'm not defensive, I'm simply being cautious. I can't risk reckless dating due to my miscalculating while. A certain suitor stands in line, I've seen in movies, most made for television. One cannot be too careful when it comes to sharing your life. I could end up a miserable wife. Well, he could be criminal. Some sort of psychopath who escaped from an institution somewhere where they don't have girls. He could have masterminded some way to find me. He could be colorblind. How untrustworthy is that? He could be less than kind. Or even worse, he could be very nice, have lovely eyes, and make me laugh, come out of hiding. What would I do with that? What if when he sees me, I like him and he knows it? What if he opens up a door and I can't close it? What happens then if when he knows me, my heart is set in motion? I'm not prepared for that, I'm scared of breaking open. But still I can't help from hoping to find someone to talk to who likes the way I am. Someone who when he sees me wants to again.
Peer through windows, watch life go by, dream of tomorrow and wonder why. The past is holding me, keeping life at bay. I wander lost in yesterday, wanting to fly, but scared to try. But if someone like you found someone like me, then suddenly nothing would ever be the same. I'd feel so alive if someone like you found secrets I long to share. All I have needed is someone there to help me see a world I've never seen before. A love to open every door to set me free so I can.
Everything has its season, everything has its time. Show me a reason and I'll soon show you a rhyme. Cats fit on the windowsill, children fit in the snow. Why do I feel I don't fit in anywhere I go? Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky. Every man has his daydreams, every man has his goals. People like the way dreams have us sticking to the soul. Thunderclouds have their lightning, nightingales have their song. And don't you see, I want my life to be something more than long. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gonna find my corner of the sky. So many men seem destined to settle for something small, but I won't rest until I know I'll have it all. So don't ask where I'm going, just listen while I'm gone. And far away you'll hear me singing softly to the dawn. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky.
as black as my skin. There's a light burning bright, showing me the way. But I know where I've been. There's a cry asking why. I pray the answer's up ahead, 'cause I know where I've been. There's a road we've been traveling. We lost so many. There's pride in my heart, 'cause I know where I'm going. Yes, I do, and I know where I've been. There's a road we must travel. There is a promise that we must make. The riches will be plenty, yeah, worth the risk and the chances we take. There's a dream, yeah. In the future, there's a struggle that we have yet to win, and there's pride in our hearts to lift us up until tomorrow. 'Cause just to sit still would be a sin. Lord knows I know where I've been.
It's very exciting to be able to participate in this activity with the theater company at Fort Lee. This theater company has offered me an opportunity to play many diva roles. The first one was Meg Brockie in Brigadoon. Then there was Ado Annie in Oklahoma, Laloom in Kismet, which hardly anybody does anymore. But my favorite diva role is Reno Sweeney in Anything Goes. The more I travel across the gravel, the more I sail the seas, the more I feel convinced of the fact New York's the town for me. Its crazy skyline is right in my line, and when I'm far away, I'm able to bear it for several hours, but then I break down and say, take me back to Manhattan, take me back to New York. I'm just longing to see once more my home on the 100th floor. Can you wonder I'm gloomy? Can you smile when I frown? I miss the east side, the west side, the north side, and the south side. So take me back to Manhattan, that dear old dirty town.
What, Taylor?
Well, we're supposed to be doing a medley from Anything Goes.
Yes, this is a number from the 62 Off-Broadway revival with Hal Linden and Eileen Rogers.
Oh,
don't you know it?
1962, the Kennedy administration.
Oh,
I must have missed that one.
Well, what do you want to sing?
Well, your song was very lovely, but I thought I would sing a song that people remember from the show.
All right, take it away.
I don't know if you're aware of this, but times have changed, and we've often rewound the clock since the Puritans got a shock when they landed on Plymouth Rock. They should try to stem instead of landing on Plymouth Rock. Plymouth Rock would land on them. In olden days, a glimpse of stocking was looked on as something shocking, but now God knows anything goes. A good author's to who once knew better words now won't. I know that you're bound to answer when I propose. Anything goes. What are you singing?
Come on, it's a great place for harmony. And they do it in the big number, you know that.
I don't know what key that was in.
Well, Patty couldn't sing it in the original key. Patty LuPone, don't you know? She had to have 7 flats.
Well, it was a little extra, but sopranos should be allowed to play Reno Sweeney too.
I understand, and I want you to know that I was greatly honored to share the stage with you in the spring production last year.
You know, I was gonna say the same thing about you, Nancy, because I've been watching you perform on stage since I was a child, so it was just such an honor to have you there every night. And what was it that you used to say to me at intermission right before I would go on stage for my big number?
I want you to be so darn good that I'll hate you for the rest of my life. We'll always be bosom buddies, friends, sisters, and pals. We'll always be bosom buddies. If life should reject you, there's me to protect you. If I say that your tongue is vicious,
if I called you uncouth,
it's simply that. Who else but a bosom buddy will sit down and tell you the truth? Though now and again I'm aware that my candid opinion may sting,
though often my frank observation might scald, I've been meaning to tell you for years, you should keep your hair natural like mine.
If I kept my hair natural like yours, I'd be bald. But, sweetie, we'll always be dear companions, my crony,
my mate.
We'll always be harmonizing. Orphan Annie and Sandy,
like Amos and Andy.
If I say that your sense of style's as far off as your youth, it's simply that. Who else but a bosom buddy would tell you the whole stinking truth?
Each time that a critic has written, your voice is the voice of a frog. Straight to your side to defend you, I rush. You know that I'm there. Each time the world makes an unkind remark, when they say, Vera Charles is the world's greatest lush, it hurts me.
If I say that your fangs are showing maim, pull in your claws, it's simply that. Who else but a bore somebody would notice the obvious flaws?
I feel it's my duty to tell you, it's time to adjust to your age. You try to be Peg of my heart when you're Lady Macbeth. Exactly how old are you, Vera? The truth.
Well, how old do you think?
Oh, I'd say somewhere between 40 and death.
But sweetie, I'll always be Alice Toklas if you'll be Gertrude Stein. And though I'll admit I diss you, I've gossiped and gloated, but I'm so devoted.
And if I say that sex and guts made you into a star, remember that. Who else but a somebody can tell you how rotten you are? Just turn to your bosom buddy for aid and affection, for health and direction, for loyalty, love, and for suit. Remember that. Who else but a bosom buddy will sit down and level, will give you the devil, will sit down and tell you the truth. I wish I could have seen you play Reno.
Well, it was great and you were fabulous. Reno is in good hands for the future.
Let's go get a drink.
You bet.
And rubble out of the smoke, out of our night of struggle, can we see a ray of hope? One pale thin ray reaching for the day. We can build a beautiful city. Yes, we can. Yes, we can. We can build a beautiful city, not a city of angels, but we can build a city of but we can start. Slowly but truly mending, brick by brick, heart by heart. Now, maybe now, we start learning how a beautiful city. Yes, perhaps we can build a beautiful city, not a city of angels, but we can build a city of men. When your trust is all but shattered, when your faith is all but killed, you can give up, bitter and battered, or you can slowly start to build a beautiful city. Yes, we can. Yes, we can. We can build a beautiful city, not a city of angels, but finally a city of men. A city of